Vsauce. I'm Jake, and you can't see me right now, even though I am directly in front of you. Since there is no light in the room, there is nothing in the visible spectrum for you to see. But that doesn't mean that there is nothing here. Let me show you. Using a FLIR thermal imaging camera, we get a visual representation of thermal radiation, or infrared radiation, the heat transferred by the release of photons. Thermal cameras report a temperature value, the effect of temperature. Instead of seeing the visible light of an object, it estimates the infrared radiation an object is emitting. And you can tell that my nose is actually colder than the rest of my body, and you can see everything around me because everything above 0 Kelvin, a temperature that we have never achieved or witnessed, glows. But generally, we don't see it since the emitted photons are not in our visible range. Also, it looks just like Predator vision from the movie Predator, which is what inspired me to borrow this camera in the first place. Let's turn on the lights for a second. Okay, everything looks normal again, and I have a refreshing cold beverage in an aluminum can, and you know it's cold because I just said it was. But if we switch back to thermal mode, you can see the extreme temperature disparity between my body and the can. Also, I just have poor hand circulation, which is why they are cold. It looks darker, and because it is reading the intensity, the label on the can is completely missing. If I rub it on my face, the temperature is immediately noticeable. It's almost like painting with temperature. Whereas when I rub it on my face without the thermal camera, I just kind of look like I have a thing for cans. Thermal cameras are incredibly fun, so we are going to do some more experiments. But before we begin, let's talk about what you are seeing, or should I say, what you aren't. Check this out. The electromagnetic spectrum is the range of all light that exists. Two of the fundamental properties of light are frequency, the number of waves that pass by in a second, and wavelength, the distance from the peak of one wave to the next. The less energetic the wave, the longer the wavelength. The shorter the wavelength, the more energetic the wave. The most energetic being gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet, and then our small spectrum of visible light. Then things slow down and we have infrared, microwave, and radio wave. When an object gets hot enough, it starts to bleed into the spectrum we see, moving from infrared to visible. You can see this with the hot door handle in my video, Could You Survive Home Alone? It becomes incandescent. It hits the Draper point, 977 degrees Fahrenheit, the temperature at which almost all solid materials glow. And the infrared spectrum isn't the only range technology has allowed us to witness. There are telescopes that can see gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet wavelengths, microwave, and radio waves. And when we see these images, we are seeing false color, a representation of the invisible spectrum, but it doesn't show what the star, nebula, or solar system would actually look like to our naked eye, since we are being shown parts of the spectrum we'd never see. Take this photo by the Chandra X-ray Observatory of the supernova remnant Cassiopeia A. This is a false color image. What is actually captured is this. Three images in the soft, medium, and hard X-ray band. You can even download some raw X-ray files from the Chandra website and create your own false color composites, if you want to give it a go. I show how to do it in the latest Dong, Do Online Now Guys episode, over on the Dong channel, link down in the description. Back to thermal cameras, there is a common misconception that they allow us to see through objects. For example, if we look at this wall, we can see the studs, the wooden beams that are on the inside, when really we are just seeing the difference in heat between the wall and the beams. We can get a glimpse at an object's emissivity, that is, how well an object emits thermal radiation. A perfect emitter is a black body, an object which absorbs all light. It doesn't reflect it or allow light to pass through, and similarly to absolute zero, it is something we have yet to witness or achieve. Let's try something else. If we take a Mylar blanket and cover me with it, you can't see me anymore, but I can see you through it. Because this is a thin plastic sheet, but it is heat reflective, so I'm hidden. But if we take a black square, like this plastic one here, you can start to see my heat radiate through the object. Pretty neat. Now that is pretty cool.
But you know what's cooler than that?
What's cooler than that, Ian?
Trash. Garbage. The gross stuff.
check them out.
So, Ian, this is just actual garbage.
Or is it?
Hey, Vsauce. Michael here. The plastic this bag is made of is opaque to visible light. You can't see through it, but it is transparent to infrared light. The infrared radiation coming off my skin passes right through it into the camera. Now, that's what I call garbage-ucational. Sort of a rubbish pun, though.
So, as you can see, you can't really see through Michael's glasses. They look more like sunglasses. It's pretty interesting. Glass acts differently in thermal vision. Normally, if I close this glass door, you can still see me, it's transparent. But if we open the door and then close it again while looking through the thermal camera, it becomes opaque. I'm no longer visible, and in fact, you can see our wonderful cameraman, Eric Langley, on the other side. Hi, Eric. Glass is designed to pass visible wavelengths and block thermal or infrared for insulation. Not only that, but just like the Mylar blanket, you're seeing the reflection on the glass as well as the window glazing. Quick side note, if you can't see glass through a thermal camera, then how can you see anything? Since traditionally, lenses are made from glass. Well, that's because thermal lenses use the element germanium instead of the traditional glass lens. So hiding behind a window would be a great way to hide from something with thermal or infrared vision. But the movie Predator tells us that there is another way. So, to recreate the scene in Predator where Arnold Schwarzenegger covers himself with mud and then makes himself invisible to the Predator's thermal vision, we need a few things. You need three strapping young men, you need a bucket full of mud, and then you need Ian shirtless.
I can do that.
But before we begin, there's two other things that we wanted to show you guys. Ooh, a balloon. But when it's inflated, you can see through it. Isn't that incredible?
Hey!
Look at that. And then another fun thing to do, if you want to draw with heat, is you grab any kind of surface, in this case the Curiosity Box, and you can see it here, it looks very colorful, there's images and stuff. But in thermal vision, there's nothing there until...
Oh yeah. Ooh, that friction's making some heat.
Oh yeah.
I can't see it though.
But now you can. It says Ink, who's the mascot for the Curiosity Box. The Curiosity Box by Vsauce, the best of box, is shipping right now for new subscribers. It is filled with amazing stuff curated by the Vsauce fellas, and it's a great way to really support your brain growth and also to support Alzheimer's research. Okay. So let's get your clothes off.
All right, let's do it. You really want me to get naked right here?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's cool.
All right.
You just do you.
All right.
Well, don't do you, do what we say.
Should the glasses come off?
Yeah, take the glasses off.
All right.
That's, yeah, maybe put your hair back a little bit.
All right.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Whoa. Oh, yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah, whatever you do, don't warn me. You know, I hear for when you're painting a wall, you might want to like sandpaper it beforehand. Maybe could have done something like that to me. Or...
Oh, is it cold?
Yeah, just a touch.
Yeah, let's get you on the ground.
All right.
Woo-hoo. Oh, that's great.
Yeah, and the face, we need to cover the face.
Yeah, make sure you do the face.
Okay.
That's really satisfying, slapping that mud on.
I don't want to hurt.
We'll keep an air bubble.
Yeah, should we get a straw, maybe?
Is this like a certified mud bath? Certified Vsauce mud bath?
Yeah, it's organic. So, it kind of worked. Everything that's covered in this mud mixture is hiding his body temperature, and you can see the parts that aren't are still radiating, but it was pretty effective. But that could also be because of the fact that this is pretty cold, right, Ian?
Yeah, it's fairly cold.
This really isn't very scientific. I just kind of wanted to cover Ian in mud. So we did it. So this was a fun experiment, right, guys?
Yeah, real fun.
And hey, be sure to go check out iDubbbz TV. It's Ian's channel. He is a fantastic young, very young talent.
Thanks, mate.
And as always,
thanks for watching.